A very pleasant good morning to you all. I welcome you all to the physics online class. I hope you are all doing good. Dear students, last class I have completed the first lesson. Did you all revise the portion? Yes? Okay. Today we are going to mark the evaluation part. Okay. Now you have to take your book from page number 13. Okay. Choose the correct answer. First we are going to mark.
Evaluation question number 1. Choose the correct answer. Inertia of a body depends on weight of the object, acceleration due to gravity of the planet, mass of the object both A and B. The correct answer is mass of an object, because inertia mainly depends upon mass. Okay, if the mass is greater means inertia will be greater. So, inertia of a body depends upon mass of the object. The second question, impulse is equal to change in momentum. Okay, already we studied what is impulse, right? So, impulse J is equal to delta P, that means change in momentum. So, impulse is equal to change in momentum. Third one, Newton's third law is applicable for a body at rest or for a body in motion or both A and B or only for bodies with equal masses. The correct answer is Newton's third law is applicable for both A and B, that is the body at rest and the body is in motion. Fourth question, plotting a graph for momentum on the x-axis and time on y-axis, slope of momentum time graph gives dash. The slope of momentum time graph gives, see, according to Newton's second law, you know, force is directly proportional to change in momentum. Okay, so change in momentum is momentum by time. Okay, so if you are plotting this graph on the x-axis momentum and the y-axis the time, the slope gives what? Change in momentum. So change in momentum depends upon force. Okay, so slope gives force. The option C. In which of the following sport the turning effect of force is used? The turning effect of the force or torque will be used in which option is the correct one? Swimming, tennis or cycling or hockey? Cycling. Okay, there only the turning effect is used, right? Then question number 6. Unit of G is meter second power minus 2. It can also be expressed as dash. See, unit of G, you all know acceleration due to gravity unit is meter second power minus 2. So here it can also be expressed as, so force is equal to mass into acceleration. So acceleration is equal to what? Acceleration due to gravity G is equal to F by M. Okay, so force by mass. So here force unit is Newton and mass unit is kilogram. So we can write Newton kilogram power minus 1. So option B, Newton kilogram power minus 1. So the unit of G is also expressed as Newton kilogram power minus 1. Then question number 7. 1 kilogram force is equal to. See, 1 kilogram force is equal to 98 into 10 to the power 4 dyne. Okay. 1 kilogram of force is equal to 98 into 10 to the power 4 dyne. If you refer page number 7, there they given 1 kilogram force is equal to 1 kilogram into 9.8 newton. Okay, newton, or in terms of dyne, we can take dyne. So 1 kilogram, 1 kilogram means we can write 10 to the power 3. Okay, so 10 to the power 3 into 9.8, but here the option is 98 into 10 to the power 4. Okay, so what we have to do means this 9.8 we have to convert into whole number. Okay, so into both the sides multiply and divided by 10. Okay, so we can get this answer 98 into 10 to the power 4 dyne. Okay, next question, 8th one. The mass of a body is measured on planet Earth is m kilogram. When it is taken to a planet of radius half that of the Earth, then its value will be dash kilogram. See, the mass remains same. Okay, already we studied from difference between mass and weight. Okay, so mass is a fundamental quantity, and one more point what we studied, it remains everywhere, it won't be changed. Okay, so the mass of the body on the planet and the earth, what is that? Same only. Okay, the value is capital M, option D, M. Next question, question number 9. Okay, if the earth shrinks to 50% of its real radius, its mass remaining the same, the weight of a body on the earth will be? See, the answer is option D. Okay, increase by 300%. Okay, now we are going to do how this in this value is came. Okay, see, once again, listen the question. If the earth shrinks to 50% of the real radius, its mass remaining the same, the weight of a body on the earth will be? See, the original radius, let us take R. Okay, and if the radius is reduced to half, that means the new radius, that is R dash, is equal to 50% of the real radius, that is 50% of R. So 50% means, you know, 50 by 100, right? So 50 by 100 of radius. So if you are cancelling, what we get? 1/2 into R. Okay, so the real the radius is now R dash is equal to 1/2 into R. Okay, so here we already know acceleration due to gravity. What's the formula? Gm by R square. Okay, so if the radius is reduced to half, means what is the acceleration due to gravity? G dash. G dash is equal to Gm by R by 2 the whole square. Okay, so here R by 2 the whole square means R square by 4. Okay, so this divided by 4, if you are taking in the numerator, 4 it will become in the numerator. So 4 Gm by R square. So G dash is equal to 4 into this Gm by R square means what? Actually, this value of G, right? So 4 into G. Now we are going to calculate the weight of a body, isn't it? Weight of a body on the earth. So weight, what is the formula for weight? Weight W is equal to M into G. Okay, so if the acceleration due to gravity is G dash, so what is the weight? W dash is equal to M into G dash value, what is that? 4G, isn't it? Otherwise, M into G dash, so G dash value is 4G. So I'm substituting here 4 into G. Okay, so M into 4G. So otherwise, what we can write? 4mg. Okay, so acceleration due to gravity is 4 times G, means the weight will be 4 times the original weight. Okay, so we can get now 4 into, so W dash is equal to 4 times the original weight. So okay, so here we are going to calculate the, so what about the change in weight? Okay, so change in weight, the final weight minus initial weight. Okay, so it is equal to W dash minus W. So it is equal to W dash means 4W minus W. So it is equal to 3 times the weight. So here they asked the question in terms of percentage. Okay, how much percentage of weight is increased? So how much percentage they are? So 3 into percentage means what? 3 into 100 times the weight is increased. So 300% the weight is increased. That's why we got the answer, or the option D. Okay, option D, what is the answer? Increased by 300%. Next question number 10. To project the rockets, which of the following principles is or required? See, for the propulsion of rocket, we already know the two principles is used, right? What are the two principles used for the rocket propulsion? The law of conservation of linear momentum and Newton's third law. So here, what is the option? Both A and C. Okay, Newton's third law and the law of conservation of linear momentum. So option D, both A and C. Next, fill in the blanks. We are going to mark the fill in the blanks. First question, to produce a displacement, dash is required. To produce a displacement, force is required. Please mark it here, force. Person just lean forward when sudden brake is applied in moving vehicle. This can be explained by inertia of motion. By convention, the clockwise moment are taken as negative and the anti-clockwise moments are taken as positive. Fourth question, dash is used to change the speed of a car. Gear. G-E-A-R, gear. Fifth question, a man of mass 100 kg has a weight of dash at the surface of the earth. See, we have to use this formula of W is equal to M into G. Okay, M value what they given? 100. So, 100 into G value what is that? 9.8. Okay, if you are multiplying, we will get the answer 980. So, 980 Newton. Next, Roman letter 3. State whether the following statements are true or false. Correct the statement if it is false. First question, the linear momentum of a system of particle is always conserved. False. Okay, should write false and write the correct statement. In the absence of external unbalanced force, the linear momentum of a system of particle is always conserved. So here write it, in the absence of external unbalanced force. In the absence of external unbalanced force. Did you all mark? Okay, the second question, both apparent weight of a person is always equal to his actual weight. Tell me whether it is true or false. False. Apparent weight, it won't be always equal to his actual weight, right? So write false. According to the condition, the apparent weight will be changed. If the lift is moving in the upward direction, the apparent weight will be what? Greater than the actual weight. So like this, it will be changing. So what we can write the correct statement? Apparent weight of a person is always not equal to his actual weight. Not equal to. Third question, weight of a body is greater at the equator and less at the polar region. False. Instead of greater, you write less. Less at the equator and more at the polar region. So cut this and write the correct statement. Here less, greater instead of write less, and less instead of write more. Question number 4. The turning a nut with a spanner having a short handle is so easy than one who with a long handle. See, already we studied this answer. Why? We need a long, why the long handle spanner is preferred to tighten the screws in the vehicles, right? So here they given short handle is so easy. So this answer is false. Okay, write false. False. And write the correct statement here. Instead of short handle, write long handle is so easy. Long. Short you cut and write long. Than one with the, instead of long, write a short handle. Okay, like that you correct the statement. Instead of short, write long. Instead of long, write short. Question number 5. There is no gravity in the orbiting space station around the earth, so the astronauts feel weightlessness. What is the reason the astronauts feel weightlessness? Yes, both the space station and the astronauts are under free fall condition. They have the equal acceleration. Okay. So, this statement is false. And right, space station and the astronauts have equal acceleration. They have equal acceleration and they are under free fall condition. Roman letter 4, match the following. First question, Newton's first law. Newton's first law, stable equilibrium of a body. Newton's first law, it is also called law of inertia, right? Stable equilibrium of a body. Newton's second law, law of force. Newton's first law, it is also called law of inertia, that is stable equilibrium of a body. Newton's second law, it is also called what? Law of force. What is Newton's second law? The force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. So, Newton's second law, law of force. Newton's third law, flying nature of bird. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction we studied, right? Some examples, while flying, the birds pushing the air in the downward direction and their body is moving in the forward direction. Okay? So, Newton's third law, example, flying nature of bird. D, law of conservation of linear momentum, propulsion of rocket. Have you all marked? Then, question number, Roman letter 5, assertion and reasoning. Question number 1. The sum of the clockwise moment is equal to the sum of the anti-clockwise moment. Reason, the principle of conservation of momentum is valid if the external force on the system is zero. See here what option is correct means. Option B, both assertion and reason are true. But the reason is the not correct explanation of assertion. See, sum of clockwise moment is equal to sum of anti-clockwise moment is what? Principle of moments. Okay, not principle of conservation of momentum. Okay. So, what is principle of moments? Sum of this clockwise moment is equal to sum of the anti-clockwise moment. Okay, but here reason, principle of conservation of momentum is given. So, this option is correct. It is not correct explanation of assertion. Question number 2, the value of G decreases at height and depth increases from the surface of the earth. The value of G decreases as height and depth increases from the surface of the earth. Reason, G depends on the mass of the object and the earth. See here, option C, assertion is true but the reason is false. Because acceleration due to gravity does not depend upon the mass, it depends upon what? Radius we already studied, right? So, acceleration due to gravity value does not depend upon the mass, depends upon what? Radius. Okay, so option C is the correct one. Then, Roman letter 6 already, you marked all the questions I think, right? Define inertia, give its classification, what page number? 2 and 3. Page number, take page number 2 and 3. Already you marked. Once again, those who did not mark, mark it, okay? Page number 2 and 3. See here, the inherent property of a body. Up to here, the definition is there. Then, classification and types. Inertia of rest, inertia of motion. With explanation, you should write, okay? Types of inertia, put the heading and write from here to next page up to here inertia direction. Okay, this one types. Then, with example, means you have to write athlete runs some distance, any one example you can write. Okay. Question number 1. Then, the second question. Question number 2, classify the types of force based on their application. Okay. So, based on the direction only, we mark this answer. Okay. But here the question is based on the application. Okay. So, I am giving the notes. Please see how to write it in the class note. Okay. So, write it. Roman letter 6, question number 2. There are two types of force. There are two types of force. One is contact force. Contact force. So, based on the application, there is two types of force. Contact force and non-contact force, right? So, contact force, write it. A force which is applied. A force which is applied by means of direct physical contact. By means of direct physical contact between two objects is known as contact force. What do you mean by contact force? A force which is applied by means of direct physical contact between two objects is known as contact force. Have you all written? Next, we have to write the examples. Pushing or pulling an object, muscular force, frictional force, compressing a spring, kicking a football, etc. Examples: pushing or pulling an object, muscular force, frictional force, compressing a spring, kicking a football. So all these are the examples of contact force. Second one, non-contact force. A force which is applied without any physical contact. A force which is applied without any physical contact between the objects is known as non-contact force. A force which is applied without any physical contact between the object is known as non-contact force. Can you say some examples of the non-contact force? Without any physical contact of the two objects, what are the forces are acting? Yes, gravitational force. Then magnetic force, right? Then electromagnetic force. Gravitational force, magnetic force and electromagnetic force, etc. Hope you are all written this answer, I think. Okay. Based on the application, two types of force. Contact force and non-contact force. Okay. Then question number 3, already we given the notes. Okay, this problem everybody written, I think. F1 is equal to 5 Newton, F2 is equal to 50 Newton. Then what is the resultant force means? Just subtract F2 minus F1, that is 15 minus 5, what's the answer? 10 Newton. Okay. And the direction is along the direction of F2, because which is the greater force, that direction only the direction of the force will be. Then differentiate mass and weight, already given the notes. Then question number 5, define moment of the couple. It is given in page number 5. Just check it once again, already we marked. Then question number 6, state the principle of moments, also given in page number 5. Then state Newton's second law of motion. It is given in page number 6. Then 8, 9 already given. Question number 11. How does an astronaut float in a space shuttle? Last class we marked, right? Page number 11 it is given. Okay. Then Roman letter 7. Some problems we have already done. And the fourth one we can do in the next class. Okay. Then question number Roman letter 8. Answer in detail. What are the types of inertia with an example? Already we marked in the Roman letter 6. Okay. Including example, we have to mark for this answer. Okay. This is a detailed answer. So, page number 2 and definition and the types we can mark already. Then along with that example also, you have to write for this long answer. Okay. Roman letter 8. Okay. Question number 1. Okay. Then state Newton's laws of motion. For this answer, you should write all the laws. Okay, you should write all the laws. State Newton first law, second law and third law we should mark. Okay, first we have to mark Newton first law. It is given in page number 3. Okay, page number 3, mark this one. The law states that. Okay, this paragraph fully have to mark. Okay, Roman letter 8, question number 2. Okay, first definition. And the next definition, Newton's second law, it is given in page number 6. Okay, page number 6, second law is given. And page number 7, Newton's third law is given. Okay, Roman letter 8, question number 2. So, page number 6, 7 and the page number 3, okay. So page number 3, first law is there, and 6 and 7. And reduce the equation of a force using the Newton's second law of motion. It is given in page number 6. Okay, page number 6, you have to write it, page number 6. First you have to write the definition, then from here to mark. Let m be the mass of a moving body from here to up to here. Okay, mass f is equal to m into mass into acceleration. Next, state and prove the law of conservation of momentum. That is given in page number 7. Okay, first you have to write this law. Okay, principle of law of conservation of momentum you should write. Okay. So, page number 7 and 8. Okay, page number 7 and 8. Mark it, page number 7 and 8. Page number 7, the definition is there. Okay, then next to page number, this diagram, then this proof, okay, this paragraph up to here. Okay, M1, V1 plus up to this equation, and this last statement also. In the absence of external force, algebraic sum of this moment after collision is numerically equal to sum algebraic sum of this momentum before collision. Question number 4, did you all mark? Okay. Then describe rocket propulsion, page number 8. Page number 8, this paragraph up to here. Okay. Up to velocity, you have to mark. Then state the universal law of gravitation. Already you marked page number 8. Okay. Page number 8. Universal law of gravitation. This law states that. Okay. This definition and this diagram. And here up to this equation and this values. Okay. You should mark for question number 8. Sorry. Question number 6. Then question number 7, give the application of universal law of gravitation, that is given in page number 12. Okay, this 5 points you should mark it. Okay, universal application of the universal law of gravitation. Okay students, that Roman letter 9, and here one question we can mark in the next class. Okay. Thank you, students. So, you have to learn all these questions. Okay.
See, learn Roman letter 1 to 6.